So what have we got for us today?
Today we are in West Seattle. We are going to be going to Don Fraser's home.
We're in West Seattle to see Don Fraser.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
It's actually made by Don Fraser. She's actually a Seattle tiki artist. And we're going to go visit her house that's literally right up the street.
Whoa.
Right up the street.
Right up the street.
Welcome to the Bamboo Grove of Westwood.
I'm Duke.
And I'm Lola.
And this is Bossa Nova Life.
Today we are in Seattle, Washington at Don Fraser's house. She's one of the founding artists in the Tiki Revival.
Check it out.
You've been into Tiki pretty much your entire life, but how did you get into it though?
Okay, so the thing I figured out about my aesthetic is it's been this lifetime of kind of trying to hone in on this vision that I couldn't identify and I didn't know where it came from, but yeah. It was something I always liked. So it wasn't because I grew up going to Disney or my parents went to Hawaii when I was a kid. I didn't have any of that. There is no Tiki or Polynesia or Hawaiiana. There's none of that in Montana. That doesn't exist. You don't. You don't see that.
Are harkening back to that.
So, I don't know where the vision came from. I have no idea. But I've been trying to perfect it for a really long time. I've been trying to work on this so long. I didn't even know it was Tiki Modern.
Yeah.
I didn't even know I was doing Tiki Modern until it started to be a thing. What people do now is they go thrifting. In the 70s, it was called junkin'.
Junkin'.
It was called junkin'. And junk stores in the 70s were exactly that. They were junk stores. There were massive piles of crap all stacked up, and it was dirty, and it smelled, and you had to dig. And that's how I found all the treasure. Nobody wanted that mid-century stuff. And some of these pieces I have actually had since I was a kid. My first set of Russell Wright dishes I've had since I was like 6 or 7.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
So back then this was all considered junk.
Yeah, nobody wanted it. It was crap.
Wow. That blows my mind, because now the stuff is like worth a lot of money. Mm-hmm.
Well, and even when I was able to, I didn't actually start collecting furniture until I moved to Seattle. So maybe 22, 23, I started collecting my own furniture, like real furniture.
Yeah.
Not your college stuff where you have your records in milk crates.
Right, adult furniture.
Right, grown up pieces. And I had an eye. I already had an eye for furniture, and I would find these pieces a lot of times on the side of the road for free. I have this Herman Miller sofa I saved from going to the dump. It's signed and dated.
The thing that kills me, I think that's the thing that's tragic about this. It's just like, say that went to the dump. That's one piece
is
gone forever.
I know, and you think, I think about Witco. How many Witco pieces have gotten thrown out because
so
people
much.
Didn't want to, you know, they just thought it was junky, heavy, gaudy stuff.
Well, Witco has a definite style, and you either love it or hate it.
I don't like all the Witco pieces. I'm pretty particular about it, and I definitely wouldn't want the Witco furniture because it's too big and heavy.
Yeah.
I like the cleaner, smaller pieces. This is Rugzotica. I've been making them for about 4 years now. They're studio made with NOS cotton rayon, rug yarns, jute backed, all my own designs. This rug in particular was at Modernism Week in Palm Springs 2 years ago. It was part of the greeting photo op
at the Palm Springs Airport. It was the Virgin America Terminal.
Nice.
So I did this specifically to go with their color scheme. This would not normally be my color scheme, but everybody loves it.
Yes. My favorite thing is Dawn. Dawn's the greatest. I love her so much. Everything she touches turns into a work of art. Like her ceilings, she makes those palm trees. I don't know if you guys knew that, but she made that.
That's amazing. Yeah, everything here is so detailed.
Yeah. She's painted the walls. She's refinished the floors. She's just a true artist.
This place is pretty amazing. There's so many small things in every single corner, but it's not like it's cluttered, it's just laid out and just really creative. So when did you start doing the whole pinup thing?
Probably about 7 years ago?
7 years ago.
I've just always been inspired by old school pinups and thought it would be fun to
Is there a specific decade that you really liked about the pinup stuff? Or?
I was really obsessed with Betty Page back in the 90s.
Yeah?
So, I think that was a lot to do with it. And then Jessica Rabbit and pretty much anything sexy ever.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, I can see the Jessica Rabbit thing with the red hair. That's pretty cool. So when it comes to tiki stuff, is that something that you kind of fell into later on? The whole tiki culture thing?
I went to Hawaii a few years ago, and I like it more for the decorations, I guess, the aesthetics,
the decor,
of it.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
The music really makes me happy. I don't really drink, so it's not about the drinks for me, but just the mood that it mm-hmm. puts you in.
So there is a issue of Bachelor Pad magazine that has you in it. Tell me about that.
There's four.
There's four?
Actually.
I didn't even know there was four.
There's one with me on the cover.
Uh-huh.
And that is the, I believe it's the nightcap edition, but that's my favorite because I'd been in them for three times before that, and then I finally got a cover, so.
That's awesome.
That made me happy. Thanks, Java.
Yeah, Java does a great job, he really does. I love Bachelor Pad so much.
Got the camera going here. So you painted the Tiki rocket ship.
Yeah. Amazing. But this was for a show quite a number of years ago, somewhere in the Midwest. And all the artists were sent a bisqueware decanter, mm-hmm. it's a decanter, to paint.
Oh,
so
wow.
So almost everybody's decanter sold except mine because I'm me. And so there it sits. I still have it. And I'm actually glad I have a lot of my original pieces.
You're telling me right now that what you have in your possession is A, tiki, B, UFO related, and C, holds liquor.
Yeah.
That should sell. Like that you need to market that like right now.
So like when did you start getting into like the painting? Like the paintings that we have behind this?
Okay, the reason I started, I have always been a watercolor painter, and some of my watercolors are in this room. And the reason I started painting in acrylics was because people who do all these group shows for tiki started getting mad at me for shipping them paintings with glass.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, well I have to figure out how to just do the acrylics, do what I want to do with the acrylics. So I started painting acrylics so I could send them to all these group shows, and it was something light and easy, just like everybody else's stuff.
Yeah.
Not something nicely framed with matte and glass, because that's
highbrow art world as opposed to lowbrow art world.
Yeah. Okay, well, which medium do you like better? Did you like the
watercolor? I like both, and I excel at both. And the thing about watercolor is you only get one shot to do it. Mm-hmm. You have to paint it correctly the first time. And this is key. And this is something my mom always told me. My whole life she said this to me, and I didn't know what the hell it meant. She said, paint your tiniest detail with your biggest brush. And that is really key to having a loose style. And a loose style is key to a good watercolor. So the reason I started painting the acrylics was because of the shows. And the reason I started doing the blues, the phthalo blues, which I call Moodzotica.
Moodzotica.
Moodzotica. It's because another artist in Tiki told me I couldn't do it.
And that's why you do it.
And that's exactly why I do it. And they become my most popular pieces.
You make a living doing this.
Yeah, this is like all I do now. Yeah, you know, it's my art.
This is your job.
Yeah, and it's because I have all these product lines developed.
Yeah.
And I spent all these years developing these product lines almost in obscurity, just doing it anyway, even though I really didn't think anybody was paying attention. But it was just enough to keep it going.
Yep.
Just enough. And I just kept designing stuff and making things and adding to it, and it all goes together and creates my particular vision of Tiki Mart. So this is where it's going. Yeah, and I've always wanted to take Tiki to high design. I'm the only one who does the kind of work who can take Tiki to high design. So I do that with the designing the fabrics and making rugs and the paintings. It all gels. So I can make a look for somebody.
So can I ask a question? And you can answer with as much as you want to.
Okay.
But I really want to know, because you are this beautiful, empowered woman doing Tiki in kind of the boys' world. How much do you want to talk about that? Or not at all? Up to you.
I actually think that eventually Ray and I are going to do an interview where I sort of talk about all of that. Most people, I don't associate with that stuff anymore, and it's freeing.
Well, I was gonna say, you have your own empowerment. Like, it may not be in
that totally free
the area you started, but you still now are elevated to this place of people respect you.
It's not. I always feel like I'm still working on that.
I think it's
a lot of people don't get past my snark and my language use.
But if your name was Mike, you could totally have both.
Oh, hell yeah!
That's what you need, Don. You need to change your name to Mike, and then all your problems will be solved.
Or change your name to D-O-N. And be like, oh.
Yeah, instead of Don, D-O-N.
Okay. Yeah. But except.
D-O-N-N.
Except that my stuff is so recognizable that I would never be able to get away with it.
No. And you don't want to. You own it.
So we've had a lovely time here with everybody at Don Fraser's house in Seattle, Washington. So from all of us at Secret Tiki Escapes to all of you, mahalo, have a lovely day.
Oh, I didn't see you there.
Well, thank you for watching our video. Do you like classic cars and rockabilly?
What about pinup and burlesque?
What about those things? How about tiki culture and mid-century modern?
Atomic culture.
All of those things could be yours. Just click like and subscribe right there. Do it. Right there.